I could just fancy one of those in me cocoa.
Fancy it's as fancy does. And I'll thank you to keep your hands off my light refreshments, Joe Buggersthorpe. There is a war on, you know.
If you keep one of those hot for me, I'll keep something hot for you.
Silly idea, Joe Buggersthorpe. I might and I might not.
It was so silly, the way it started. I'd gone into Wolverton as usual on a Thursday to change my library book and order a coconut. And I'd just popped into the refreshment room at Cranningley Junction when Dolly Ansnacott invited me to share a mince pie.
Hello.
I'm frightfully lucky. I've got a mince pie. I want to go halves.
No, thanks.
Oh, go on. I can't be such a hog as to have a whole one.
Will you have them again?
I couldn't say, I'm sure. Ask me no questions and you'll be told no lies.
Well, it is nearly Christmas.
This speech is awfully tough.
And then, I don't know how it happened. It's so long since I'd had a mince pie. I suppose I'd forgotten how to eat it. Somehow I missed my mouth altogether, put it straight in my eye.
Oh! No, really.
Perhaps
I could just have some water.
Do you have any water, woman behind the counter? That's for me to know and you to find out. There's war on, if you haven't noticed.
Oh, this is ridiculous.
Should I hit you over the head with a cup?
No, really, Dolly.
Good thump with a basin, that's my tip. Do you have one? Oh, right, Sam, maddening. My train leaves in a moment.
No, you must go.
I can't miss it. I'm expecting a kipper.
No, do go, Dolly. I should be quite all right.
And that's when he came over.
May I help? I'm a doctor. Turn to the light, please. That's it. And look up.
I hadn't noticed him before. He was just a hat and a newspaper. Once I'd got that blessed mince pie out of my eye, I could see he was rather good looking.
Orange peel.
But thank you, but I won't take care of it. I can't believe I can't.
He even managed to charm Vida, you know, the dragon from the refreshment room.
Could you bring two teas over, please? This lady's had rather a shock.
Well, those that don't ask don't win no parsnips, that's for sure. And I've a nice tin of orange pekoe I keep for the middle classes.
It was such fun, Fred. We talked about everything under the sun. Milkman, Agatha Christie, even the manufacture of teapots, I seem to remember. It was as if we'd known each other all our lives.
You married, Bob?
Yes, my wife's a bit of an old trout, I'm afraid.
It sounds as if you don't care for her very much.
Oh, not at all. We're very devoted. It's just that she can be rather vicious and she takes drugs.
I see.
It's my fault, I'm afraid. I brought them home for a joke. How about you?
Fred's a dear. We've been married for 14 years. No, 15. Two children, Bill and Sally. And I don't know. It's not that one isn't happy.
It's become rather humdrum.
That's it. You're very perceptive. Golly, it's the 14. I should have to cross the other platform.
Look, don't go, please. I know we've only just met, but would you come to the pictures with me one afternoon?
Don't be ridiculous. I couldn't possibly.
All right, then, here's another suggestion. I'm going out to a leper colony tomorrow on the boat train to Nairobi from King's Cross. Could you leave all this and start a new life with me?
And I wanted to do it, Fred. And I'd love to be able to say it was the thought of your dear old face that stopped me. But it wasn't.
Please, Catherine.
It was Dolly Ansnacott. She'd had some ridiculous accident.
Whatever's the matter, Dolly? Would you believe it? My scout has been entirely torn away by the 4-8 from Holly Van Gold.
What to do?
Your train, my scout!
Oh! Oh, the man is so trousered in left looking.
Trousers kill the cat, Joe Buggersthorpe.
No, I mean, no.
There's a clean apron in the meat safe and let that be an entry.
I can't believe I'm showing my gusset in a refreshment room.
Put one in the front and one in the back.
And that was it, really. I caught the 4:27. You never even noticed I was late.
I told him. I shall have rabbit for dinner if I have to wring its neck myself.
Dolly, you're ridiculous.
Such a silly story, isn't it? But what I really can't explain, dear, dear Fred, is how I came to run away with Dolly Ansnacott.